Hi, welcome to this webinar with COMAP and with me, Sophie Kelleux-Gagnon. I suggest today to talk about the sensitivity head, and I'm going to show you an efficient range of thermostatic heads, so all the versions we have about the sensitivity head. So for the overview, I'm going to start with the description of the sensitivity head. After that, I'm going to talk about the efficiency of the head, and after the options. So I'm going to introduce all the options: the valve connection, the bright version, the restricted version, the position zero, the tamper evident ring, the anti-theft ring, and the reinforced sensitivity head. So let's move on the description of the sensitivity head. You can see the head on the screen. So it's a bright head because it's a pure white. It makes it elegant and stylish because the fins here were redesigned in order to make the head beautiful. There are some discrete finishes, and you can see that the numbers here, so the position, are very discrete, are written very discreetly. There is also a pin here in order to lock the right temperature, so it's necessary to insert it. Here you can see we can insert the pin at this place in order to lock the position 3, so in order to control 20 degrees in the room. Now, still about the description, so it's a thermostatic head, so there is a wheel. The liquid sensor, so the thermostatic sensor is a liquid sensor. There is also a spring, the position, so on the cover of the head. The fixing nut here, two examples, it can be M28 or M30, so it's necessary in that case to screw the head onto the valve. And for the position, there is an antifreeze position which corresponds to 7 degrees, and a position from 1 to 5, so from 11 degrees to 28 degrees. The most common position is position 3 because it's about 20 degrees. The installation of the radiator, it's very easy to install the head on the thermostatic valve. It's necessary to install it in the horizontal position in order to avoid the effect of the temperature, of the water temperature on the sensor. So in order to have an accurate way of controlling the temperature, it's necessary to set the head in an horizontal position. So in order to install it very easily, we recommend to set the head on the position 5, and it will be easy to screw the head onto the valve when it's in position 5. There is no need of tool. No tool is required in order to tighten the head. And after that, it's just necessary to adjust the desired position, for example, position 3. The way of operating now. We are going to take the example that the head is on position 3. That means we want to control an ambient temperature of 20 degrees. So imagine now, you can see here the head and the valve on the screen. Imagine the temperature is low in the room, for example, 17 degrees. At 17 degrees, the liquid sensor is going to contract because of the low temperature. When it contracts, the needles, you can see here, and the flat is going up, and consequently, as a result, the water is going to run through the valve and is going into the radiator in order to heat the room. So Imagine the opposite. That means it's hot in the room, so there is some contribution, and the temperature in the room is about 23 degrees, for example. So the liquid sensor we have here is going to expand. When it expands, it pushes onto the needles and the flap, and the needles and the flap is going down, so the valve is closed. And when it's closed, it's not possible for the water to run through the valve and to go into the radiator to heat the room. So that's the way the thermostatic head and valve control the temperature in the room. So let's talk now about the efficiency. About the efficiency, so the head and the valve with the head, all these products are certified, so are in line with the EN215 standard. In this standard, many parameters are certified, and among these parameters, there are four features. So the hysteresis, the water temperature impact, so that means the water temperature, the water which is behind the head, so into the pipe, close to the head. The response time of the head and the delta P, so the pressure drop impact. And these four parameters have an impact of the response of the head. So it generates an uncertainty on the temperature control. For example, the hysteresis effect is about 0.15 degrees. So it's in Kelvin, that means the international temperature. So that's the result here for the sensitivity 0.2. What is the 0.2? It's the value of the VT. The VT, it's a French parameter which gives the information of the efficiency of the thermostatic set, that means the thermostatic head plus the thermostatic valve. So the VT, it's the control accuracy. To calculate the VT, it's necessary to know the hysteresis here and the water temperature impact. In this case, the VT is 0.2. If the VT is very low, that means the head is very efficient. So the VT is used in France today in order to calculate the energy consumption for the house, for example. It's going to be included in the standard EN215. So it's important today to know that this calculation exists. There is also another sensitivity head, which is the sensitivity 0.1. That means the VT is equal to 0.1. So this head is more efficient than the one I've just showed you, because the VT value is lower. That's the most efficient head that exists on the market today. And that means I can show you now the most efficient solution in the market regarding the energy consumption and the comfort. So it's the sensitivity head with the VT 0.1. And if we add this head and we screw this head on the AutoSAR, which is a thermostatic valve, which is the auto-balancing thermostatic valve, in that case, as AutoSAR is very accurate to control the flow through the radiator, we have a solution which is very efficient regarding energy saving and which is very efficient regarding the comfort. There is no extra consumption for regarding the energy, so no extra consumption, whatever happened, whatever is going on into the network. And for the comfort, as the head is able to control very accurately the temperature, the room temperature, it's very comfortable. The accessories now. So first, the valve connection, so M28, M30 and clip. The M28, it's for the connection to the COMAP thermostatic valve. The M30, it enables to connect the head onto all M30 valves. And the clip solution is to connect the head onto the downforce valves. The Braille version, so sensitive Braille, of course, it's for partially sighted or blind people. The Braille writing is for the position three. So the position three, as I said before, it's the common position. Everybody uses the head with the position three. So the position three is written in Braille. It's the case for the classic sensitivity and for the restricted sensitivity. And I'm going to present you this restricted sensitivity. Restricted sensitivity, it's a head. With this head, we can control a temperature up to 20 degrees. It's not possible to control a temperature higher than 20 degrees. So that means the last position is position three. So the application here, it's the social landlord application. In order for the social landlord to control the cost, the energy costs for the tenants, and in the same way to control the invoice for the tenants. And as you can see, the position three is written in Braille. The position zero now, as I said before, the first position for the classic sensitivity is with the star here. It's the antifreeze position, so 7 degrees. That means even at this position, there is a very small water flow through the valve. So with the position zero, that means there is no temperature to control. And it's the way to close the water supply. So it's for the application, it's when the owner or the tenant wants to have an action on the radiator. For example, to remove the radiator and to change it. And it may be also in order to avoid what we can that we can call a parasitic energy consumption, so for the position seven. Now the anti-theft nut. So with this nut, it's impossible to unscrew the thermostatic head. There is no access to the screw. You can see that in the picture. So it's used when the before delivering the building, if the installer wants to install all the heads, to avoid the head to be stolen, this anti-theft nut is for this application, and it has to be broken if we want to remove it. Something interesting is that even with this nut, it's possible to set the temperature, so to adjust the desired temperature. Now, the tamper-evident ring, there is also with this ring an anti-theft solution. So it's impossible to screw, to unscrew the head when the tamper-evident ring is installed. But in that case, it's not possible to have an action on the temperature adjustment. So it prevents to change the setting temperature. It's for the application, it's for the buildings open to the public to avoid people to change the set point and also to avoid people to steal the head. The reinforced sensitivity now, we can know that we have a reinforced sensitivity because of the R written on the body of the head. So It deals with the resistance to bending. The standard resistance to bending, so it's from the standard EN215, it's 600 Newton. With this reinforced solidity, the resistance to bending is 900 Newton. If we add the tamper-evident ring, the resistance to bending is now 1,100 Newton. So it's better. And it's in order to be in line with the resistance to bending, which is required for the building open to the public. And in that case, for the building open to the public, the resistance to bending required is 1,000 Newton. So about a word about the technical features, the wheel is the same. What has changed is the nut engagement. It's made of a resin, more resistant. The resin is different than from the classic head. And so the bending resistance down is reinforced. As a conclusion now, the Sanzity head, it's an efficient solution and it's adapted for all the buildings. It's suitable for all applications. There is an anti-theft nut to prevent the head to be stolen, so before delivering the building. We offer the reinforced head, but also for the building open to the public. There is a tamper-evident ring to prevent to change the set point for the temperature to be controlled. The position zero to close the water supply. The restricting head also for the social landlord in order to control the cost, the energy costs for the tenants. For the valve connection, we talked about M28, M30, and the clip solution. And at the end, the braille version for example, the social landlord applications and for all people who need a braille writing on the head. This webinar is finished now, and I thank you for attending it. You can join us on the social media, and you can join us on CoExpert, which is the magazine for people, for specialists, for plumbers, for example, and people who work on heating network, cooling network, and so on. I wish you a nice day. And take care. Bye-bye.